Hi, Alex here from Rebeloper.com and welcome back to AES, the App Store Domination. And today we are going to talk about bundle IDs and how they are generated with Xcode. So without further ado, let's get to work. Okay, when you create a new project, you create essentially a new bundle ID, but that needs to be registered in the developer portal of Apple. Now, once you set to this to be registered automatically with Xcode, you expect it to be automatically registered, but it is not the case, well, at this time. So I will show you a little tip today that will make that happen. So let's create a new Xcode project and maybe just go and let's create a new project here. Let me just minimize this one. And it will be a single view application. It doesn't really matter now. What matters is this product name. So let's see. And this is, as you can see, it has been created bundle identifier. Well, it is shown here that your bundle identifier is comp.rebeloper.registeringBundleID. Well, it will be not the same for you, but you can see it there. So let's click on next and let's place this onto our desktop. Let's create it. And here we have our bundle ID. Now, signing, it says automatically manage signing, and we have our provisioning profile here and our signing certificate. Now, let's go and test if this is actually saved into the developer portal. So let's open up Google Chrome here. Just minimize that. And let's create a new window. And let's go to developer.apple.com. Click on account, sign in if you already are not signed in, and go to certificates, IDs, and profiles. Okay, and select app IDs, and let's search for our ID. And if we recall correctly, we have something like bundle ID. Let's hit return, and we don't have that. Okay, we have something else here, but we don't have that Xcode generated a bundle identifier as our app ID under the developer portal. So what you need to do, and this is where the good tip comes in, is that you need to go into the capability, and of course, you may try to automatically check and uncheck and check, automatically manage signing, select your team, and it will not take effect. What you need to do is go into capabilities and enable any of the capabilities. In my experience, if I just enable in-app purchases, that will trigger this in-app purchase. That will trigger the creation of our bundle ID. And now let us just maybe refresh and maybe wait a few seconds or a few minutes. For now, let me just, well, maybe it has been already created. Let's type in here, bundle ID. Let's see if it is. And there it is, com.rebeloper.registeringBundleID. And that is how you can tackle this issue. I hope you enjoyed this video. If you did, go ahead and create your bundle IDs as usual and make sure that they are registered in the developer portal, and I will see you in the next one. Good stuff. Now, if you want to see more of this video and want to boost your app business, go ahead and take a look at my 30 days challenge, App Store Domination. Go ahead and click the link down below and I will see you inside ASD, App Store Domination. Let's get to work.